Yeah, I'm Sasikumar. I work with CDAC. I'm at the Bombay Center. Yeah. And my primary activities are I look after a group on artificial intelligence, which includes a focus on educational applications. I also have a group on educational technology and also on open source software. And I see a lot of synergy among all these three different areas. So I'm trying to build on these to create some innovative software applications,
yeah,
which can enhance the value of computer usage in the education area at whatever levels. Obviously, yeah, the kind of strategy that you use at school level or upper primary or college level and professional level will be different. So we are trying to look at different aspects in some of these things.
Doctor, as far as free software and open source is concerned, what is the application for education in a country like India? What are the tools that we could use very effectively here?
Open source and education, I see a lot of mindset match in the first place. So I think, and not surprisingly, a lot of academic institutions are very strongly involved in open source. They share that mindset, because I think both education and open source shares this idea of sharing as the basic concept. And in terms of directly software relevance, I think there are again two, three angles. One is the fact that all these softwares are available with the source code, means that those who get to study them can actually study them in depth, understanding the capabilities, understanding the way things are implemented. This is primarily for people who are interested in the computer side, software development side. On the second side is that there is a huge amount of software resources available to support learning. This includes learning management systems, content management systems, website development systems, audio editing, video editing, multimedia creation, you name it. All of these, there are extremely good, very powerful, nice tools available.
Not so user-friendly, maybe?
Oh, they are very good. Actually, if you look at something in the popularity that a software like Moodle enjoys in India as well as abroad, it beats pretty much any commercial learning management system that you know of today.
I see.
Okay. Even in India, there are lots of people who are using Moodle as the institutional portal.
Moodle.
Okay. Right. And I don't think there is anybody who, any other system which has that kind of popularity.
I see.
It is very simple. It's a straight WYSIWYG kind of interface, which means what you see is what you get.
Yeah.
The teacher and the students share the same view, so there is no mismatching. Okay, how will it look like for the student? Issues don't apply. Very rich in functionality. So you want a discussion board, wiki, blog, content hosting, playing, assessment, project submission, you name it. Pretty much everything is there.
I see.
Okay. And even today, people are even creating add-on utilities for things like, fee payment, okay, which was not a focus in the beginning.
I see.
But even that is now becoming available as an additional module on this.
I see.
And it's also available in a number of languages.
I see.
We have ourselves tried to localize it into Hindi.
I see.
And the localization is a pretty straightforward process, because a lot of the text is available in separate files. So if any of you are interested in, we'll tell you what to do. You can take up those files, just change all the text into your native language, and merge it back, and your Moodle is in Kannada or Telugu or Tamil. Okay. So it is rich.
Yeah.
And similarly, Drupal, there are lots of systems across the world which are running on Drupal kind of platform. There are other similar systems also, but we have used Drupal and we find it very rich. Open source portal, a couple of portals that we have developed for other people, they all run on Drupal.
I see.
It is rich. It even supports multilingual portals. We are actually trying to enhance it to make that integration a little more seamless, so
yeah,
you can link into translation systems and things like that.
As far as software for younger children go, are there any particular tools you would recommend?
Yeah, I don't have offhand list there, but I have looked at a lot of resources, and maybe I think on the portal I might be able to find some specific things, but there are the K-12 segment in the US terms, which is our school level. There are lots of animation packages and multimedia systems for different subject levels, which shows, for example, how the blood flows in the body, or the digestive system's functioning, or mathematical simulations for simple constructs. A lot of these are, this is what I was going to come to as the third type of open source usage in education. A lot of people have created these kinds of high quality interactive content. So
yeah,
these are actually software, not plain text or media that you record. So these are available in plenty. Okay, unfortunately, they are not grouped together. They are not sort of organized. So it's something that is still an open area to hunt around and pick them up.
And what are the difficulties in spreading these tools in a country like India?
I think it is a question of somebody taking the initiative. One, I think you need to be aware, which is which is something that we need to tell the teachers that, look, there are these tools available and which you can use. Second is that these tools by themselves don't stand alone. I mean, you need to integrate them into the curricula, into the your way of teaching. You know, for example, if I have a tool which can illustrate, let's say, how water flows through different terrains. Okay, I mean, just that tool which allows me to set the different terrains. I can create a hill, I can create a valley, I can create a forest, and then pump water and see how it flows. The students need a lot of initiative to be able to use this to learn about how water would flow. But whereas if a teacher can use this into the classroom, show some demonstrations, set up some examples and say, okay, now let's create a hill and then see what happens to this river. And suddenly the river changes direction.
Right.
Okay. And then you go give the students some assignment and say, okay, now create a landscape like, you know, let's say Goa or Kerala, which is, you know, has a particular structure. Create a landscape and then create a river for point 1, 2, and 3 and see how the river would, what path it would take. And come back and tell me what you found. Okay, if you can do this kind of integration into the classroom, where the student, when he goes to this application, he has a particular task in mind, that will enhance. But this is something that the teacher has to do. I mean, I think I'm not saying that they don't want to do it.
Yeah.
You need to make them aware. You need to build this kind of setup
motivate
in place.
Yeah.
So once you do that, I don't think there is any other hassle. So these are open and freely shareable, so there are no licensing issue. They normally run on a simple plain browser, so even, you know, no major software requirements are there, and no particular infrastructure requirements. All you need is possibly just a net connection. Some of them can even be installed, I mean downloaded and installed on your machine, so I think even that's not a major concern.
Lastly, what's your URL of the portal?
The Open Source Resource Center is ossrc.org.in. I'm also trying to create some resources on my own URL at wiki. That is thelittleshashi.wiki.com.
Okay, the little Shashi.
That is my common ID which I use for Gmail and etc.
Okay.
So I think my Gmail address is also same thing, thelittleshashi@gmail.com. So you can write to me, I can tell you more about it, and I also try SASI.
Thanks. Thank you so much.